Hi, welcome to my new video. This is about stock trading. It's for beginners. It's for someone who wants to trade in stocks or future markets or commodities or any other trading which has a chart pattern. So this is the beginning of a beginning lesson, I would say. So what are the things you must learn to be a stock trader? So I have listed out some 4 points which is in the red color. So the first thing is the news, and the second thing is the levels, third thing is the chart pattern, fourth thing is the confidence to trade. We will now see about these things one by one. So the first thing is called as news. So we know that the stock market behaves bullish or bearish sentiment prevails in the market due to the news in the market. So when there is a stock and there is any positive news, it turns into next day we see traders buying the stock. So it's a bullish sentiment. And you see a bad news in a stock, some bad negative or bad news in the stock in the evening, and the next day you see the stock falling down or losing its value. So that's a bearish sentiment. So the sentiments are based on the news, and I recommend using any online portals, financial portals, to like you must improve your skill of learning news daily. You should be updated with the news, because news is the factor that creates greed or fear with the traders. So traders are not like investors. They are not going to have their money for a very long time. So traders, they want to take money maximum in 1 to 3 days, or at the maximum they are going to trade for 1 week, almost 5 trading sessions. So they depend on news. Every news they will turn into bullish or bearish trade patterns. So you have to be a little updated with what are the news happening. So I recommend you watching CNBC channel or any financial news channel every day, and reading some news on regular basis. So you will learn about many fundamental factors or fundamental key points which may be useful in the stock market. And the next thing we are going to see what affects the stock price is the trading levels. So trading levels is nothing but it's a technical term. So you see that people, you might have seen people creating lot of buy levels and sell levels. So how do they create? They create using Fibonacci series of ratios of numbers and GAN series of ratios of numbers, the popular one being square of 9. You can find these online calculators everywhere. You can use Excel sheets also to create your bullish and bearish levels. And there are sometimes there are something called as a bull zone and a bear zone. So in the bull zone, say there is a news, people are thinking that market will go down. So but actually the market reacts to the opposite side. This is because called the psychological level. There are some psychological covers levels where even the news is bad, the stock market reacts in the other way. So that's what called as a bull zone. Bull zone is nothing but the market being trending in the positive direction, and bear zone is nothing but the market trending in the negative direction or trending lower. So you can use the levels. Simple level I will use in my trading is the Fibonacci levels, or sometimes I use the square of 9. But we are not sure that the buy and sell actually happen. Say if you get a buy signal in using the GAN level, so we cannot be 100% sure that trade is going to click and we are going to make money. So we'll see what are the other things to look after. So the next thing is the chart pattern. This is very important, because whatever levels you might have seen, like MetaStock and AMI Broker software, and you can write the formula for it. and you will get a buy or sell signal. But not all buy and sell are profitable. So there are some reasons only one similar say like a particular pattern that is very successful. I'll call it as a chart pattern, bullish chart pattern and bearish chart pattern. So you can read a lot of candlestick patterns which will explain this about chart patterns. So you can see this W pattern is a strong reversal, it's a bullish reversal, and double top or maybe like head and shoulder pattern, which is a strong bearish pattern. So you must know to read the technical chart, and mostly I use the candlestick pattern charts, which are very effective, and rather than using the bar chart or line chart, candlestick chart pattern is very effective. And once you start trading, you will develop a skill which is called as price action theory. So looking at the price, you'll make a trade. You don't need to look after the news, don't need to look after the levels. So chart patterns is very effective, and we'll find it how. The next last one, which is the confidence to trade. So you have to, as a trader, you have to maintain stop loss. Even though you're 100% confident, you have to maintain stop loss, which is 2% of your total amount that you have allocated for trading. And never average a stock which is already in loss. Say you bought a stock today, it has gone down, and you are still holding it. Tomorrow if it goes again down, don't average it, don't buy it again. Like you can average it and sometime you can sell it back. Don't think that. If you are in loss and if you are in a doubt, get out of the trade. You'll find a lot of opportunities, and one trade can ruin your whole system. And maintain patience, keep using trailing stop loss. Once you find the trade is in your direction, and you have to like wait for the target to achieve, keep trailing your stop loss. Never trade more than what you can afford to use. A lot of people use are very greedy or want to make money in quick time. So they invest a lot of money, they want to trade double the quantity, triple the quantity, 10 times the quantity, and they make very false trades. So these are the four things. And once you develop trading as a habit, it is a habit. Once you make successful trades, you will gain confidence, and you'll be able to trade using the price action alone.